Hello, I am Mr. Lee Kam Sir. This video clip is to discuss with you the writing of chemical equations. If you are a beginner of writing chemical equations, you need to take note of the following. First of all, the substances involved in a chemical equations, you better classify them into the following types. For ionic compounds, for example, sodium chloride, you need to write NaCl. For sulfur oxide, you need to write, say, Ag2O. That means you should be able to determine the formula of the ionic compound. For covalent compounds, for example, water, of course, you write H2O. For carbon dioxide, you write CO2. For covalent elements, that means some nonmetals. For hydrogen, be careful, you need to write the formula of the molecule, that means the molecular formula, for example, H2 for hydrogen, O2 for oxygen. And then for metals, you just write the chemical symbol, so K for potassium, Fe for iron, and so on. And then finally, sometimes you may come across with carbon, then you simply write C for carbon. Okay, so let's start. I will demonstrate to you some examples how to balance an equation first, but always remember a chemical equation must be balanced. So let me show you how to balance the equation in the question number 1A here. Every time when you are to balance a chemical equation, you have to check on both sides, okay? The number of atoms for each element. So let's have a check now. For zinc on the left, we have one zinc atom. On the right, we also have one zinc atom. So the number of zinc atoms is balanced. However, on the left, we found two O atoms. So maybe I write down two O atoms. But on the right hand side, I just found one O atom, so I've put down one O. That means the number of O atoms is not balanced right now, so you have to add some numbers. Every time when you are to add numbers, you can only add numbers before each reactant or product. That means the green lines, on the green lines, you can only show numbers. So how to go on? Earlier, we already checked the number of O atoms on both sides, and we found that there are two O atoms on the left and one O atom on the right. So you have to multiply the whole formula ZnO by 2. So you write the 2 here in order to do the step 1 of balancing this chemical equation. After you do that, on the right hand side, there are totally two O atoms. So the number of O atoms is balanced. However, once you put the 2 here, you also multiply the number of zinc atoms by 2. So on the right hand side right now, you have 2 zinc atoms. But on the left, as we checked earlier, we just have 1 zinc atom. So now you have to multiply this by 2, so that on the left hand side, you also have 2 zinc atoms. So after you do this, this is the step 2. You balance this chemical equation correctly. So let me show you another example. So let's move on to part B. So by part B, this time we noticed that on the left hand side we have 2 hydrogen atoms, while on the right hand side we have 3 hydrogen atoms. So maybe I put it down like this, 2H on the left, 3H atoms on the right. So the number of H atoms is not balanced yet, so we have to balance the number of hydrogen atoms right now. So what should you do? Okay, so I think you are clever enough. This time I don't draw the green lines, I just put the number here. Yes, you have to put the 3 here, and you have to put the 2 here. By doing this, you multiply the H2 by 3, so altogether on the left hand side right now you got 6 H atoms. After you put the 2 on the right hand side before ammonia, NH3, then altogether again 2 times 3 equals to 6. So you got also 6 H atoms on the right. So the number of H atoms is balanced. And then you check the number of N atoms. So this time on the right hand side you got 2 N atoms. On the left hand side, oh yes, you also got 2 N atoms. So the number of N atoms is also balanced. So this is already a balanced chemical equation. So question number 1B is finished. Let's move on to some other exercises. So I have a question number 2 here. So maybe again I try to demonstrate to you some parts. So let me show you how to deal with part C. So this time you are asked to convert the word equation into a chemical equation. So your task first of all is to convert all the reactants and products from names to formula or symbol. So sulfur oxide, first of all, sulfur oxide. Recall what you learned from the topic ionic bonding. So sulfur oxide is an ionic compound, right? It comes from sulfur ion, Ag plus, and oxide ion, O2 minus. So after you interchange the two numbers, you get the ratio 2:1. That means first of all, you have to write the formula of sulfur oxide correctly. That should be Ag2O. And then on the right hand side, sulfur, oh, it is a metal. So you write the chemical symbol Ag. Oxygen, metal or non-metal? Yes, it is a non-metal and it is also a covalent non-metal. So you have to write the molecular formula O2, right? First of all, you have to got all these formula and chemical symbols correct. And then next, what is the second step? Yes, you have to balance this chemical equation. So what should you do this time? What should you do? You can only add numbers here, here, or here if necessary, okay? So this time, if I were you, I will check the number of O atoms on both sides, okay? So on the left, I found 1 O atom. On the right, I found 2 O atoms. Therefore, I have to write the 2 here so that on the left hand side, right now, I got 2 O atoms. And then by doing this, I found that I also multiply the formula Ag2O, the whole formula, by 2. Therefore, right now I got 2 times 2 equals 4, 4 Ag atoms on the left. But there is only 1 Ag on the right, so I have to put the 4 here so that on the left hand side there are 4 Ag atoms. So by doing the above steps, you balance this chemical equation correctly. Okay, next, let's move on to question number 3, which appears to be a structured question, and not structured question, actually this is just another example, okay, another practice. So this time I think I will try to again work on one part. For example, part B. This time you are provided with a description, not a word equation. You have to extract the important information about the reactants and products, and then you write the chemical equation, of course a balanced chemical equation. So sodium is burnt in oxygen, just like before. Sodium, a metal, you write the chemical symbol Na. Oxygen, it is covalent non-metal, you write the molecular formula O2. And then sodium oxide, it is an ionic compound. Again, you have to apply what you learned in the topic ionic bonding. So Na plus, O2 minus, right? Sodium ion and oxide ion, and then interchange the two numbers, you get the ratio 2:1. So the formula of sodium oxide is Na2O. Then you already put down all the chemical symbol or formula for the reactants and products. Now the next step is of course to balance the chemical equation. So what should you do? Okay, the idea is quite similar to the one before. Okay, this time similarly you have to check the number of O atoms on the left and then on the right. On the left two O atoms, on the right only one, so you have to put the two here. But after you did that, you found that the two is actually multiplying the whole formula Na2O. So on the left, on the right, right now you got 4Na because 2 times 2 equals 4. So on the left you have to put the 4 here. Okay, by doing all this you balanced this chemical equation, and this is of course the answer for this question. Okay, so maybe I try to show you one more question. Yes, this one. Okay, this one, question number 4. Yes, this time it is really a structured question. So have a look at the question. When a magnesium ribbon, so you have to extract the important information. This is of course one reactant. It's strongly heated in a gas jar containing nitrogen gas. Oh, nitrogen is another reactant. A chemical reaction occurred and magnesium nitride is produced. Produced, that means it is a product. So part A, write a word equation for the reaction involved. So this earlier you found that you got one reactant, two reactant to give one product. So you just extract the information and then write it like this. Then you got the word equation, magnesium plus nitrogen to give the product magnesium nitride. This is already part A because you are asked to write the word equation. And then part B, of course, you are also asked to write the chemical equation, and of course this must be a balanced one. So let's work it out together. Magnesium metal, we write the symbol Mg. Nitrogen non-metal covalent, we write the molecular formula N2. And then magnesium nitride, it is an ionic compound. What is its formula? Okay, maybe we do some rough work here. Magnesium nitride comes from magnesium ion Mg2+, together with the anion nitride, N3-, right? Okay, so 3 to 2 being the required ratio. So the formula for magnesium nitride is Mg3N2. Okay, of course this is not finished because the equation is not balanced yet. So you have to balance the chemical equation. I think after some warm up you can work out the balanced chemical equation by yourself, right? So what number have you to put? Yes, you have to put the 3 here. Okay, so this time I'm not going to explain the reasons behind, so I think you can also work this out. Okay, before the end of this video, I would like to go on with this question. And then in part C and part D, you found that you are asked to draw electron diagrams. So part C first. Nitrogen molecule. Actually, earlier you already write the N2 for nitrogen molecule in the part B, the chemical equation already. But this time in part C, you are required to draw the electron diagram showing electrons in the outermost shells only. So how to do that? So recall what you learned in the topic covalent bonding. Over there you learn the drawing of electron diagram of molecules. So N2, of course there should be two nitrogen atoms sharing their electrons together. Okay, so first of all draw two circles, one for each nitrogen atom, and then each nitrogen atom, how many outermost shell electrons are there before the sharing of electrons? Yes, it is a group 5 element, so on the outermost shell there are 5 electrons. It wants to become stable, that means it wants to have 8 electrons in the outermost shell. So from 5 to 8, so each nitrogen atom needs to get 3 more electrons. But this time, you know, both the nitrogen atoms have to share the electrons. So if it needs 3 electrons more, then it shares 3 electrons first. So this is the nitrogen atom on the left. Of course, after sharing 3 electrons, as there are totally 5 outermost shell electrons in the nitrogen atom, so 2 electrons remained not shared. For the nitrogen atom on the right hand side, of course, we may use a circle to represent its electrons. So just like the N atom on the left, it shares 3 electrons, leaving 2 electrons not shared, like this. So by doing this, both nitrogen atoms attain the octet structure, octet of electrons, that means 8 electrons in the outermost shell. So this is the correct answer already. Finally, let's talk about part D. Part D this time, you are asked to draw the electron diagram of magnesium nitride. So make sure you know that magnesium nitride is an ionic compound. So the electrons are not going to be shared this time. Instead, there should be a transfer of electrons. Of course, after the transfer of electrons, each Mg atom and the N atom, both of them, I mean, will become the ions. So for an ionic compound, if you are asked to draw the electron diagram, you simply draw the cations, okay, the cation on the left, Mg, and since Mg is a cation, or you may say it is a metal ion, from atom to ion, the process is losing electrons. That means the outermost shell electrons of the Mg atom had been lost. Of course, the magnesium atom loses 2 electrons, so we draw Mg 2 plus. How about the nitride, N3 minus? We have to draw the nitride ion, the electron diagram next on the right hand side of it. Of course, you may draw the square bracket first. Normally, you may draw one circle because you are only expected to show the outermost shell electrons. So after gaining 3 more electrons, a nitrogen atom will have 8 electrons in the outermost shell. So maybe I just use process to represent its electrons. So bear in mind that the formation of a nitride ion from a nitrogen atom is done by gaining 3 electrons. So the charge of a nitride ion is 3 minus. So after you draw these 2 ions, the cation and the anion, it is still not finished. You have to finally show the ratio. As the formula for magnesium nitride is Mg3N2, as I said earlier, so finally you have to put the 3 here, meaning 3Mg 2 plus, and 2 here, meaning 2N3 minus. So by doing this, you got the correct answer. So this is the correct answer for the electron diagram of the ionic compound magnesium nitride, showing electrons in the outermost shells only. So I hope this video clip can help you understand more and more how to write chemical equation, and towards the end, this part is serving as a revision for drawing electron diagrams. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.